In case you're not up to date musically on the scene, I'm going to introduce RAYE, Black Mascara. I've referred to her in my previous reaction, and it was around November on the Graham Norton show. It's a very famous chat show in England, all over the world. He introduces the stars on his show. And one of the singers was RAYE, and she caught my attention. I had to react to the song. So I did, and it's got a slow response because my channel is not universally known as much as Graham Norton's channel, but I still favour her, and I'm catching up with her catalogue at the moment. Why do I compare her to Lady Gaga? I'll tell you why, very quickly. She writes her own music, she writes her own lyrics, she's a phenomenal artiste. She supported Lewis Capaldi, whom I watched the documentary on Lewis and his illness, and I thought, my God, he's got a syndrome. I can't think of the first word of it. It's just escaped me. But back to RAYE, Black Mascara. She's a phenomenon. This is an amazing, amazing dance record. Now, a lot of people have said, we love her. We don't know why she's underrated. But to go from a Lewis Capaldi support act to doing her own solo tour, details are in the description. Check her links and you will get tickets for the shows. She's also coming to Dublin to the Apollo. She's going to be sold out. I believe the tickets are sold already. One or the other. Because my mind is just about this song. It's phenomenal, catchy, and everything a good dance tune should be. You know, England produces some of the most incredible artists in the world. And what disappoints me is, and last year's was an exception. I'm going to say that in Turin. Last year's was phenomenal. Again, because it's that time of the evening and I've worked very hard all day, I've just escapes me who represented England in Eurovision. But my partner loved the song. I wasn't flavoured by it, but then it grew me after Eurovision and I realised what a phenomenon he was. Raised another one. She's just got everything. And where Lady Gaga stopped writing for everybody and started writing for herself is when her career changed, and the woman behind the lyrics and the music stepped forward. RAYE has done the same as well. So there's a lot of similarities. Now, when you say Lady Gaga's a diva, has millions of fans, trust me, RAYE is catching up. RAYE, you are the English phenomenon of today and proves that the artists that should be representing England in the Eurovision are artists like yourself. I was thinking, if this particular video had gone forth for Eurovision, she'd have walked away with it. Simply walked away with it. The music is infectious. I hit the repeat button 3 or 4 times, unintentionally. So I'm admitting it's one of only 5 reactions in my career as a music reactor I've hit the repeat button, and you'll find out why. It's uniquely unique as a dance track. It's so infectious and it's great music and great lyrically. Today, I'm just going to give you all about RAYE and Black Mascara and her forthcoming album straight after. There's no real thing about the lyrics, breakdown of the lyrics. It's about the album. It's about the video. It's about the lyrics, but just more informative. It's a question and answer interview. And I'll give recognition to the person who interviewed her all after we've heard her phenomenally catchy song. Take it away, RAYE and Black Mascara.
Once you see my black mascara run from you,
you made your bed, lied your lies, serious. Tell them hoes to be minding they business. Heart broke, but I'm still looking like millions. Six shots down, so I can't feel this. Talking my ear off, cocaine. Got a bitch gassed up, propane. Now I can't come down, or it pours, or underneath my eyes, how it rains. There's clouds up high, but the stars on the ceiling of the Royce. I hear this pain drown every other noise. You talk to me dumb, that you didn't have a choice. I'm here now, fucked up, thinking there's a why. I'm out here sinking in these dark nights, nights, oh yeah.
Wasn't that just fresh pop at its absolute supreme best? Absolutely phenomenal. And she is underrated at the moment. She's not being spoken about as much. And within the industry, there is a prejudicial element. When a young rising star comes up, the Americans tend to turn the other way because they have their own stars and they have many of them. So she's up there trying to compete. But when you write lyrics like that and you are producing music that is so fresh and soothing to the ears, it's eargasmic, and you just absorb the beauty of the freshness of it, the catchiness of it, the wonderment of your music, it's simply sensational. RAYE, congratulations, three blues. And I want to give a shout out to DJ Connor, who interviewed her as part of Ones to Watch, a website. I'll leave the link in the description. Arguably the most famous Ones to Watch artist who's yet to release their debut album, RAYE is about to launch into what we suspect will be the meteoric part of her career. She certainly is. Wanting to know more, especially what it took to get there, DJ Connor reached out to this soon-be icon. In my view, DJ Connor, I have to say she is an icon. He asked, who is RAYE? She replied, I'm a 24-year-old South London woman. I grew up in Croydon, but I was born in Tooting. I've been a singer-songwriter for 10 years and I'm in love with music. My favourite colour is green, hey, and I like my job. Then the most important question about today's video, what is it all about? Black Mascara, she replied, is about a pretty dark story of my trust being betrayed by somebody in a really messed up way that was tough for me to deal with and sent me into a terrible place. I went to the studio and I was not in a good way, and I remember that day was pretty sad, to be honest. I just wrote that song about that situation and what I was dealing with. I can't listen to sad songs and be in a dark place when I'm sad. I needed to create something that gave me some place to put my pain. So I felt like the electronic vibe was perfect for that. It certainly is healing. And I'll explain. When you are in a situation in life, everyone, and you are at your worst ebb, just like that, and you're so low, it's like listening to RAYE's music. And her meteoric, well said, DJ, her meteoric rise to fame, which will be forthcoming very soon, and a global phenomenon, as I said in the very beginning of the video, is all ahead of her. But she suffered bad places and times and sadness, just like the rest of us, she's human. And my answer is, when you're in that place, sometimes you need to do the complete opposite process of the way you think to alleviate the state you're in. In other words, if you're in a dark place, how do you bring a bit of balance and brightness into it? You uplift the spirits. And what the eyes see, the heart feels, but what the ears listen to is what can resonate all the way down into your soul and just give you that feeling of accomplishment, really, that it's working, that it's lifting, that your mindset is about a good vibe when you're in a sad place. It's like yin and yang, as I often talk about. It's meeting the two and marrying them. And that's what she means by that. I needed to create something that gave some place to put my pain, she says. Beautifully put. And hers is in the lyrics and the music. And the electronic vibe was the perfect way, right? And to be kind of honest, she says, and she continues, painful story, but it helped me heal. It was my medicine. I listened to that song every day for a month, and it really helped me. Trust me, Ray, I'm with you on this one. This is described as the only dance track on your forthcoming album, called My 21st Century Blues. Given it's so good, why? And she answered, basically, I'm in the place of my career now. I'm independent. I've just got to trust my gut, and my gut wants to express a lot of different sonics and sounds. I'm aware I've become popular from a lot of dance records, but it's not necessarily the lane that I would have taken. And I would agree to that, because if you listen, I'm going to attach my other reaction to Ray, because if you listen to the Graham Norton's guest appearance that she did, you will see that her vocal range is so powerful, and how she hits the high notes, and the ballad is so strong that you must listen to it to get both sides to this artist. So she continues, and I loved dance music, which is why I needed to have a dance song on that record. But I want to, you know, I'm aware I'll probably lose fans in the process as well, but I'm just trying to be true to myself. Ray, for every corner you turn, there'll be somebody walking out of a door that you'll peek and see. But when you look to the side, you'll wonder why there are so many other doors. And that's to cope with the amount of people that we're walking through to say, hi, Ray, I found you. Trust me. Honest and integral, she continues, and in my opinion, a lot more than just dance genre. I'm a songwriter of the highest caliber, Ray. And I love all different genres. That's what my channel's about. That's why you're on board. It's all about different genres from all around the world to prove the music industry isn't dead. And that's what you're proving. And all forms of expression, me too. And I have no rules that I have to stick to anymore. Here, being a creator on YouTube, ditching my university job at Trinity College here in Dublin, I have become so free. I understand where you're coming from. You might write the music, Ray, and the lyrics, but I write my own story. I'm an author of 3 books. I love writing, I love being creative too. And I love expressing myself through videos. And this is what this is all about. The video, she says, is elegantly styled and well choreographed. How did you settle on the visual for the song? She answered, well, I wanted a concept that reflected what I went through. I've been really digging into my visuals in this part of my life. I love dance, contemporary dance. There were so many different inspirations as well as we played with for the movement. Still, I just wanted a video that artistically reflected a really dark story and somehow made it tangible and beautiful. And I'll tell you how you did it. And I'm going to say it to you, Ray. If you don't mind me saying, Ray, every persuasion was in the video. It might have been female dancers, who cares? It's about incorporating different elements of society. There was Asian, there was Black, there was everything in the video. Cultural inputs put in there as regards skin color, dance movements, everything. And that woman at the very end, Ray, that was twisted, is like all your emotions are twisted in the body. And you reflected that beautifully. And that has to be applauded by the choreographer who read your lyrics and said, we'll have a dancer who can do this twist. There's been quite a few of them in different videos on YouTube, but what it accentuates, what it projects in your lyrics is just the fact that it's when you were all twisted and all turned and everything, and you turn a dark situation in the light, you walk away twisting, turning, getting rid of all that's got you in knots. Beautifully done. I watch boxing documentaries and I find that discipline very inspiring, which I definitely lack in life, don't we all, right? But still, it's something I'm looking forward to incorporate into my life. I feel like I can be disciplined. There's no limit to what I can achieve. So I've been watching many documentaries on incredible musicians, but that's music layered, so I guess that doesn't count. But yeah, documentaries and spending time with my dog, Yoshi. Wow, I have a similar name on my channel. There you go, lots of similarities, right? He keeps me very down to earth, don't they? I've got Paco sleeping there at the moment and I love taking him on walks. Oh, Ray, me and you are twins, making conversations with random strangers and collecting stories. I have to come to London to meet you. And we'd just sit, Croydon, you name it, and we'd just have a blast. I can see you and me in belly laughs. It'd be great. Your soapbox, anything you want to say. Pay songwriters, hear, hear. The industry needs to pay songwriters. There are many things in this industry behind closed doors that are allowed to continue happening. And I will be as annoying and loud as I need to be in this subject, regardless of what anyone thinks. I don't care. I've seen for myself what's happening and it's wrong and it needs to change. There is a manipulation. And if we were sitting for that coffee, I'd fill you in, Ray, as much as you'd be shouting. Because it needs a voice. I couldn't be the voice. But boy, have I got speaking to you. Who are your ones to watch? And she said, there's a French artist called La La Lace. She's released a body of work called Sun System. And I think it's amazing. Another, Lulu Zulu. And her visuals are amazing. Tara Lilly, who's a good friend of hers, who I went to Brit school with. Wow, a lot of people coming out of Brit school. Don't forget, Adele did. And who else went through there? Leona Lewis, which is so beautiful. I'm really proud of her. She continues, her artistry is unmatched. And that is Tara Lilly, whose song Hotel Amour I'm featuring, believe it or not. It's coming up soon. Which is so beautiful, and I'm really proud of her and her art. Her artistry is unmatched, and I can't wait for the world to take her seriously as she deserves. Now, all I can say is that is the end of the interview. That's the end of the introduction to Black Mascara, the album, and Ray. All the details in the description. Thanks for listening. Take care.